Like, let me greet the saints in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Allow me to repeat that one. I greet you all in the name of Jesus. Amen. And this morning, the title of our message is Michael Shall Stand. Michael shall stand.
Michael puts a subum.
And we read from Daniel chapter 12.
So from the morning of Daniel, as after was in Shumina,
we read verse 1.
So from the Daniel 12, we find verse 1.
Ah, yes. Daniel chapter 12, verse 1.
And at that time shall Michael stand up.
Amen.
The great prince which standeth for the children of thy people. Mm-hmm. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was since there was a nation, even to that same time.
Amen.
And at that time thy people shall be delivered, everyone that shall be found written in the book.
Now the Bible is saying,
the Bible is in
at that time, Michael shall stand.
Michael tots a sugum em
the great prince which stands for your people.
Lord Samuel Bantuba.
And there shall be a time of trouble. Such as never was. Hallelujah, friends.
Amen.
Now the Bible is saying,
the Bible is in at
that time.
Alice's car.
Now in Greek. We have got two words that are translated time. The first one is Kairos. Then the second one is Chronos. Now what is Chronos? Chronos symbolizes the clock time.
Chronos,
but Kairos symbolizes the right time. So what the Bible is saying is at the right time, Michael is going to stand. So Chronos is that time that is always ticking. Seconds leads to minutes. Minutes leads to hours. Hours leads to days. Days to weeks. Weeks to months, months to years. Let me talk to my young people. In your Chronos, there is a Kairos. In your Chronos, there is a Kairos to get married. Hallelujah, friends. Ungajaki before the Kairos.
Don't rush before Kairos.
And again, ungaputi. And make sure you put it at the right Kairos.
And don't delay.
Married my brother, my sister. So in the Greek translation of the Old Testament, the word Kairos is used in the book of Ecclesiastes. There is a time for everything. There is a time to be born. And there is a time to die. The word that is translated there is Kairos. When someone asks, what time is it? He is asking the Chronos. But if someone will ask, what is it time for? That is Kairos.
No, Kairos.
In Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 and 5.
Galatians 4, 4 and 5.
The Bible says,
the Bible is
in the fullness of time.
What was it?
No, it's time. Like, let me not speak for the Bible.
I'm not
the Bible. We are going to read Galatians chapter 4.
As in Galatians chapter 4,
verse 4 and 5.
Verse 4 and 5.
At that time,
and this was calm.
Michael shall stand.
Michael just a sugu.
At the right time, Michael will stand.
Michael just a sugu.
At the appointed time, Michael shall stand.
Galatians 4, verse 4.
Mm-hmm.
Galatians chapter 4, verse number 4 and 5.
Yes.
But when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth
His Son,
made of a woman,
yes,
made under the law,
yeah,
to redeem them that were under the law.
Alleluia, friends.
That
the Bible is saying
adoptions of sons.
The Bible reads in
the fullness of time. Jesus came.
Jesus was here.
So the word that was translated here, it is not chronos.
Actually, chronos,
but kairos.
What was kairos?
So in the fullness of time, the Bible is saying,
the Bible reads,
Michael shall stand.
Michael,
and there is going to be a time of trouble. Who then is the Michael that you are talking about? Allow me to say to you, friends, Michael is none other than Jesus himself. Now, Christ has got so many titles in the Bible. He is the Prince of Peace. He is the Messiah. He is the Alpha and the Omega. He is the faithful witness. But here in Daniel, he is referred to as Michael. Now, if you read in your
Bible,
5 times you are going to meet the name Michael. Revelation chapter 12, verse 7. The Bible says there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels, they fought against the dragon and his angels. The Bible says, now is full, hallelujah for that one. So friends, whenever there is a war, whenever there is a battle, Christ is not the Messiah. He is not
Emmanuel.
Whenever there is a war, Christ is Michael. You can read again in Jude, verse 9. The Bible says, there was a dispute there about the body of Moses. And Michael, the archangel, contended with the devil. So whenever there is a battle, Christ is Michael. Number 3. We meet also in the book of Daniel. Christ is referred to as Michael. Daniel chapter 10.
Daniel is
going to read from verse 12. You can read it.
Yes.
Daniel chapter 10. From verse 12. Michael is also mentioned there.
Verse 12. Daniel chapter 10.
Daniel chapter 10, verse number 12.
Yeah.
Then said unto me,
what's it mean?
Fear not, Daniel.
Fear not, Daniel.
For from the first day
that you set your heart to understand, yes?
Yes. And to chasten thyself before thy God.
Yes.
Thy words were heard.
Yeah.
And I am come for thy ways.
Now Daniel had received a vision.
Daniel chapter 8,
Daniel chapter 9. 8, Daniel chapter
9. A
2,300 days
vision.
Now if you read chapter 10, verse 1. The Bible says, in the 3rd year of Cyrus, king of Persia, a thing was revealed unto Daniel, whose name was called Belteshazzar. And the thing was true, but the time appointed was long. And he understood the thing, and had understanding of the vision. Now it was at this time, after he had received this vision, Gabriel was sent.
Gabriel, what you mean?
Verse 18, my brother.
Verse 13.
But the prince of the kingdom of Persia,
withstood me
121 days. But lo, Michael,
hallelujah.
One of the chief priests,
came to help me, hallelujah. Yes?
And I remained there with the kings of Persia.
Hallelujah. So Daniel had been praying here.
Daniel
had been praying. And he had been praying for 21 days. Now Gabriel is sent. But along the way, the Bible said there was a roadblock. The prince of Persia, who is Satan himself,
Satan
one of him,
he blocked his path.
But the Bible is saying in verse 18. But thank God, because a Michael, who is the prince? Let me read again verse 18. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 120 days. But no Michael, he came and he helped me. So this is what is happening. Gabriel has an important message that he is supposed to take to Daniel. Now Daniel, he is praying for 21 days. And Gabriel is going with the message. Along the way, as I said, the one who has ordered, you will not take this message. Friends, this is why I am challenging you today to read the book of Daniel, especially the 2300 days, because Satan knew putting this message is very important. This is why Gabriel. So Michael came and he said, hey, remove your pressure. So that the message can go to where it is. Verse 21. We meet again, Michael. Yes, in the same chapter, chapter 10.
Verse number 21.
Yeah.
But I will show you that which is noted in the scripture of truth.
Yeah.
And there is no more that hold with in these things.
Yeah.
But Michael, your prince.
Hallelujah, friends. So what are we saying this morning? Who is Michael? Michael is none other than Jesus Christ. Michael is the name that Christ takes when there is a war or when there is a battle. Now I know Emaswati, they are peaceful people. I don't know if there was a war before. But I know they are peaceful people. Now where I come from, there was a war. And when people were going for war, someone could take another name. For example, my former vice president, his name was Joyce Mujuro. But yes, she was going for war. She was not Joyce Mujuro. But she was Teoraino. Teoraino simply means the teacher in the
There's
something that is known as Kubutse Gamdala. I don't know if I'm correct.
You are going to be
initiated.
My name is Okot.
But
when I go to be initiated,
I am no longer Okot. But I get another name. I was burying my young man in Fofanele. Now he died while serving his king. I told me good names, given him Liga Male
Utseka.
And his name was Tula Umtseka. I also had great love names like Insla Ubula. This is what is happening here. When Christ is going for war, he is not Emmanuel. When he is going for war, he is not the Messiah. But he is Michael. Let me talk to you, friends, this morning. I don't know what you are going through in your life. I don't know the battle that you are fighting. But let me tell you, if you are fighting any battle in your life, I would sing you die. You don't need the pastor, but you need Michael. If you have got any battle that you are fighting, you need Michael. That's where I come from. I've seen many of my loved ones. They put to risky bets. And wherever they go, they say, "Ni ahamba na papa wanu." Let me tell you, my friends,
coronavirus does not care.
Coronavirus,
whether you have a risk event or not. If you shake people's hands during this time, with your risk event, coronavirus will catch you. So if you want to be safe from the coronavirus, make sure you are out of the people.
The risk event will not work.
Others have got holy oil in their wardrobes. Even as I speak, some have got holy oil in their wardrobes. Friends, coronavirus does not care.
And
I want to thank the Lord because he has revealed himself.
Let us not put our hopes, our trust in human beings.
Right now, myself as a pastor, I'm also locked down. I'm also in my house. I'm not supposed to go out. Now, if you had put your trust in me, you are in trouble. Blessed are you, my brother, my sister, if you put your trust in the Lord. So, friends, Satan is not afraid of a
misbehavior.
He is not afraid of imbiter. He is not afraid of the holy oil. He is not afraid of the anointing oil. He is only afraid of my
husband.
Whatever you are going through in your life, you don't need a bumper sticker or a
bumper.
You need Michael. So Michael shall stand. This is what the Bible says.
Not sure by me.
But for him to stand, it means he has been seated all this time.
Hebrews
chapter 8, and this one, let's read it.
Yeah, Hebrews chapter 8.
What does it say? The Bible is saying, at that time, in the fullness of time, Michael, who is Jesus Christ, he is going to stand. What are you saying this morning? For him to stand, it means he has been seated. Verse 1, chapter 8.
Verse 5, chapter 8.
Yeah.
Now of the things which have been spoken, this is the Son.
Yeah.
We have such a high priest, who is set on the right hand of the throne of the majesty in the heavens.
So the Bible is saying, friends, this is the conclusion of the matter. We have a high priest who is seated at the right hand of the Father. Chapter 10,
verse 12.
What does it say? Hebrews chapter 10, verse 12.
10, verse 12.
Hebrews chapter 10 verse 12.
Yeah.
But this man, after he had offered
one sacrifice
for sins,
yeah,
forever, sat down on the right hand of God.
So this is what Jesus did.
No, just that's all right.
This is the man that we are reading about.
No,
after offering one sacrifice for all our sins, he sat down on the right hand. This is what the Bible is saying. As we speak, Michael is seated on the right hand of the Father. Verse 19. Mark chapter 16, we'll read this one, verse 19.
Mark 16, verse 19.
Yes. Mark 16, we are reading verse 19.
Mark chapter 16, verse number 19.
Yeah.
So then, after the Lord has spoken,
after the Lord has spoken unto them, and
he was received up into heaven,
yeah,
and sat on the right hand of God.
So he was received to heaven, and he sat at the right hand of the Father. This is what the Bible is saying. Christ is seated at the right hand of the Father. And his seat is the mercy seat. I want you to remind you this morning, my brothers and my sisters, it was the right hand of the Father which caused the ark in the time It was again the right hand which wrought on the wall in Daniel chapter 5. So what does the right hand of the Father represent? This is just judgment.
No.
So Christ is seated.
Christ will say,
on top, let me say, of the judgment.
Now,
my brother, let's read Revelation chapter 15, verse 1.
Let's go to Psalm 15, verse 1.
So, Christ is seated.
Christ is seated.
On the mercy seat.
Revelation
chapter 15, verse 1.
Psalm 15, verse 1.
What does the Bible say?
The Bible reads in heaven.
And I saw in heaven.
Yes.
Great and marvelous.
Great and marvelous.
Seven angels. Having seven plagues.
Having seven plagues.
For in them,
the wrath of God is filled. So the Bible is saying. I saw another sign. I saw seven angels. With the seven last plagues. In these seven last plagues. The wrath of God is filled. So Christ is seated.
Christ is
on the right hand of the Father. Which we say.
This is it.
The right hand represents judgment. There are seven bombs, if I can say, that are ready to explode at any time. But thank God, because Jesus Christ is still seated on the mercy seat. Thank God, because Christ is on the mercy seat. On the right hand of the Father. This is why today, you see,
he leaves his home.
And she comes back alive and
flies.
There is someone who is seated on the mercy seat. This is why today, when you see a thief, he goes out to steal and he comes back alive. After that, he actually praises the Lord. Praise the Lord, because today I was successful. It's because there is someone who is seated on the mercy seat. And what is he doing today? He is interceding on your behalf. He is interceding on my behalf. Whenever I sin, when I kneel down and I confess my sins, with outstretched arms, he says to the Father, I have forgiven you.
And
this is what I died for. Luke chapter 13, verse 6 to 9. We are going to read this one.
Luke 13, 6 to 9. So
Luke chapter 13, verse 6 to 9. Yes.
Luke 13, 6 to 9.
Yeah.
He spoke also this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard. And he came and sought fruits thereon, and found none. Then said he unto the dresser of the vineyard, behold, these 3 years I come seeking for fruits on this fig tree, and find none. Cut it down. Why cumbereth it on the ground?
This is what is happening in this parable. There was this fig tree, but it was not bearing fruit. Now the command is given here. Cut this fig tree down. Why are we cumbering the ground? Yes.
And he answered unto him, Lord, let it alone this year also. Till I shall dig about it. And if it be a fruit, well. And if not, then after thou can cut it down.
This is what is happening today. Christ with outstretched arms.
Christ,
he's just saying to the Father, just one more year, my Father. I am going to work on him. I will make it a point. I will send preacher after preacher. I will even allow the Swaziland conference to make sure they hear the live stream. So that whilst he is seated in the camp part of his word, he will be getting the message. Just give him another year, Lord. Maybe he's going to repent. Preacher after preacher, I will do what I can so that he can repent. This is what is happening. Christ is seated on the mercy seat. And he is just saying, one more year. Just one more year. He is interceding on our behalf. Friends, I put my issues. As I stand here, I'm not perfect. As you are there, you are also not perfect. And if you have not yet liked our Facebook page, make sure that you do so, so that you don't miss any of our videos. So in conclusion, my brothers and my sisters, my trial is going to stand. Things are not going to remain yet. We will not continue like this. We will not continue fighting diseases like that. My trial is going to stand one day. We will not continue like this, my brothers and my sisters. We will not continue bearing our lives. One day, my turn is going to stop. I've lost my loved ones. Yes, also I lost my loved ones.
Now,
but it will not continue like that. My
turn
is going to stop. We are going to pray this morning. And I'm going to ask my pastor, Pastor Tamini,
he's going to pray for us.
Amen.
Amen.
Andazeni uNkulunkulu nemusa nomthando lohlala ekhaya ezulwini nasetinza wontombo. Siyabonga ngokuthi nangalesi sikhathi ngokuthi usigcinile wasilondoloda kwaze kwabangalesi sikhathi. Ngokuthi nanoma tenteka ngositonke tinto, siqinisekiswe ngokuthi usinikela sona ngokuthi tinto ngeke tihlale nje. Ngokuthi nanoma ngosithikhona tonke timo ngokuthi lesendlula kilo ngawo onke imali. Usitona ngokuthi endlini lakho namuhla. Inzaba kayiphelela liyeta langa lapho khona Mikhayela yosukuma khona sithi Nkosi kuze kube ngolu suku lapho Mikhayela yosukuma khona sigcine ngephasi kwempilo yakho ngoba ngaphandle kwakho Nkosi asisiluthu kodwa uma sinawe singakhona kwenta konke ngoba wena Nkosi uyawuhlala njalo usiqinise sibusise manje ngelele kuhle Nkosi beligama lakho ngaJesu Kristu ophila kona lokuya masinyane siyathandaza amen.